Greetings, fellow drone fans. Today we're going to show you how to set up your storm32 gimbal, especially if you buy it online and you have issues. It's very simple. Now, the first thing that you want to do is set it up correctly and make sure that it's properly aimed or directed. So for this thing, you have to verify that the main board is correctly aiming towards the north of the drone, and this is very important. Some of the boards will actually have it an arrow on the top and the lowermost part of the camera where the IMU sensors are. We check out this diagram and we noticed, for example, that the reset buttons are actually on the right hand side, so that means that the north is pointing in this direction and the USB port is on the southernmost part or direction. So that's what we are assuming based on the diagram. However, you have to open the uppermost part of the gimbal and check out to see if there is an arrow pointing. Some models do have it, others don't. So you have to verify it first. As we said, check it out. Once you put your camera, the second thing that you have to check out is the exit ports for the FPV. Why? Because the arm has a controller in one side. So if you have your camera with the cable on exit on the other side, you want to make sure that it doesn't bounces or touches the motor on the gimbal, otherwise it will not work. What we had to do in this case is switch the arm. You don't have to disarm anything. Only thing you need to do is just reverse the arm by twisting it and then rotating it on its axis, and you will have it properly corrected. So that's the second most important thing to do. Make sure you know where your FPV cable is coming from your camera. As you can see, this is the second IMU sensor right there. Now, the third most important thing is that you need to have two wires and check out the pins connections on your board. You want to control, in our case, the pitch, because the yaw is controlled automatically and we don't have no interest on the roll. So check out the wires that are properly connected, as you can see, for each motor, and then check out the pins. You always have to have a ground pin and one of the pins connected to your flight controller. In this case, it's a pixhawk. If you only have one wire, it will not work. So we have the green wire connected to the pixhawk port 9, which is actually one of the analog ports, but we've defined it as 9. Remember that your pixhawk board has 8 digital ports and 6 analog ports. So we have, as you can see, both the signal cable or wire and the negative wire on port 1, but it's actually port 9 if we use it as a digital port. So that's something that you have to be very aware. We will show you later how you set it up on your pixhawk, or the mission planner, sorry. Now, the pixhawk is very important for you guys to go into the computer and set it up. We will show you now, because we have done it already, how it works. And this is the third most important part. You need to program your radio control and define on what channel do you want to have the control of your gimbal. We now connect our second battery, which is the one that controls the gimbal. So we have two batteries. Now, you will notice the flashing LED light, and that's okay. It will flash because what it's doing is booting itself, and it will start to calibrate and look for the proper position for the camera. Once it is defined, you will hear a small beep, and the flashing will stop, and that means that it has properly booted. So that's very important. You can see strong solid light. Now what we will do is take our controller and we will show you. We have it set it on channel 6 on a radio controller, and it's one of the small rotating knobs that we will use for controlling the pitch angle on the camera. Remember to have both wires connected to the pixhawk. That's very important. A lot of people usually only have one wire and it will not work. You need to have a complete circuit. So it means you need to have a positive and, or the signal and the negative one. As you can see, we rotated it and it's tilting 90 degrees down, or we can make it rotate 90 degrees upwards. It's up to you. We know that you are not going to use it upwards, but since the controller is set up that way, we don't want to tamper with it, nor the angles, because it just makes it complicated. So we just leave it in neutral, which is pretty much horizontal, and then turn it the knob to the right or clockwise, and it will lower the gimbal or tilt it downwards. Now, this is very important. You need to set up some stuff on your mission planner on your computer for your pixel controller to work. As you remember, we were turning the knob on our spectrum radio, which is actually a Taranis QX7, and it's, as you can see, on channel 6. You need to do a channel calibration, and that's very important, but that's another video. You will find a lot of it on the YouTube channels, so we're not going to show it, but this is very simple. As you can see, we're turning the knob, and the gimbal is rotating, so it means that it's on channel 6. Remember that. Very important, because you will need to configure on your flight controller what channel 6 will be controlling, which is the gimbal. Don't forget about it. So now we go and check out here on, I think it's additional parameters or optional software, sorry, and we'll look for camera gimbal. As you can see, there it is, and we'll go all the way up and it says type, and we leave it as servo, and then we choose servo 9. Remember the channel, it was channel 9, it was channel 6, sorry, but it was on input 9 on your pixhawk. Don't forget that it was on the analog, which is number 1, but it will be pin number 9 if we carry or continue using it as a digital output. So you can see we have 8 digital and 6 analog, but we will use it as digital number 9. That's very important, don't forget about it. Now, you need to program your storm32 controller, and there's a site that is made by Oli32, which you can download the software and the firmware for setting up your gimbal. We're not going to show you how to set it up, because there's a good video from AndyRC that explains you pretty much how to work it. You just need to be aware that this board has 2 IMUs, which are inertial moment units or sensors, and pretty much what they will tell you is the position of the camera. Also check out which firmware version you have. In our case, it's firmware 0.9, and it's very important, because if you're going to update the firmware on the board, if you upload the wrong firmware, you will pretty much damage the controller. So that's something that you have to be very aware. Check out the paper that comes with the controller and make sure you're uploading the firmware that it's supposed to be. We're not uploading any firmware because the one that we have works perfectly, but still we need to download the software that we need in a computer in order to pretty much configure the gimbal. We're not going to upload a new firmware, but we will download a software that will allow us to control the Storm32 board on the gimbal, and that's very important. So we scroll all the way down until we'll find the OGBC tool, I think it's called, or the GBC tool, sorry, Windows GUI, and this will help us set up the parameters that we need. You need to do a calibration, you need to tilt your drone, because you need to pretty much define which is your north. Remember that this is very important, otherwise it will not work. Check out Andy RC's videos on this aspect, because it's a long video and you have to pay a lot of attention. Just make sure that you download the proper OGBC tool, especially the GUI software that you will need to access the menu on the board. You will also need to have not a micro, but a mini USB cable, which is the one that is a little bit bigger than the micro USB, so you can connect to the board from your computer, and that's very important. Also make sure that you have the Storm32 gimbal with 2 IMUs, one on the camera support and one on the main board, because it uses 2 boards for reference. We will click and load it so you can see how it is, but we're not going to run through the whole calibration process. The thing is that once you have all of your gimbals set up, you need to do a calibration. That's very important so that it works properly. As you can see, it's a very simple interface, it's not complicated. We are not going to upload new firmware on the board, so we're not going to show you that, but we'll explain you how you can get it. This is the micro, no, I'm sorry, the mini USB cable, not the micro. and you connect it to the board, you will see that at the back end there's a port for the USB on this board, so you just connect it to it. There's no need to have it powered, you just connect it and it will draw power from the USB port, so it's okay. But follow the instructions on the Andy RC's tutorial about setting up the gimbal. We're not going to show it because it's really extensive, it's about 15-20 minutes. Just make sure that whatever version of the gimbal you have, in our case, our IMU sensor on the lowermost part doesn't have an arrow pointing to which is the north, because this is a double-sided arm. You can twist it to the other side and you will have it as a left arm or a right arm. But when you're doing the calibration, you can define which is your north or which is your south. So that's a very good thing because it allows you to twist or change the position of the camera depending on what type of camera you have. And as we said, it depends a lot on the FPV connectors. If you have the FPV connectors on the right, you want to have your arm grabbing from the left. And backwards if it's on the other side. So it's very important. When you're doing the calibration, it will ask you to tilt your drone. And that is when it's going to define which is the north and which is the south. So it's very important. Don't forget about it. And also you need to make sure that you have the uppermost part properly aimed at the north. That board must always be aim at the north, otherwise the calibration will not be successful. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.